Hello and welcome back. Hope you are doing well. Today we will talk about some ways how to find out if a noun is masculine or feminine in French. If you have not subscribed yet to my channel, please do subscribe to my channel and press a thumbs up and share my videos with your friends. If you subscribe, you will see a small bell button.
Press that hard.
And you will find no sound of a bell like this, but you will get the notifications of my upcoming videos. Today we will talk about some ways to find out if a noun is masculine or feminine. It is a very common and important question which comes to your mind when you are learning French. After watching this video till the end, you will have a clear idea about this. I will ask you some very easy questions and you will have to answer to these questions. I will tell the answers by the end of this video. Before I start the questions, you need to know l'article indéfini, and the link is given over there. And voila, here's some questions for you. Put un or une in front of the given nouns. Sœur, marché, chambre, culture, profession. Sister, market, bedroom, culture, profession. Let's learn how to identify a noun if it is masculine or feminine. In French, as you know very well, we have got only two genders, masculine and feminine. And all nouns are considered as either masculine or feminine. Even a chair is feminine and a wall is masculine. As such, there is no rule to identify if a noun is masculine or it is feminine. But to start with, we all look at the ending of the noun, which may give us a hint about its gender. Hack number one. If a noun is ending with an E, it might be a feminine noun, like pluie, poubelle, horloge, image, chaise, chemise, etc. And if a noun is not ending with an E, it might be masculine. But the big twist is, there is a large number of exceptions to this. There are many nouns which end with an E, but they are not feminine. And there are many feminine nouns which do not end with an E. How to identify them? Here's a suggestion from me. I always tell to my students to increase the amount of reading. When you are reading a lot, you are coming across a large number of nouns. The meanings you can find easily in a dictionary. And when you are doing dictionary work, always look at its gender. And if you find a noun which doesn't end with an E, but it is feminine, or it is ending with an E, but it is masculine, note them down because they are exceptional nouns. Make a list of all exceptional nouns in the backside of your notebook or in a separate notebook. This is the only way to keep in mind which noun is masculine and which noun is feminine.
Also, this habit will grow a sense of identification in you. Whenever you will be reading, you will understand if a noun is masculine or feminine.
I am giving you an example on how it will look in your notebook. Un parapluie, un livre, une maison, une fleur, etc. Parapluie is ending with an E, but it is masculine. Fleur is not ending with an E, but it is feminine. And always write un or une in front of these nouns and within brackets, masculine or feminine.
So you must read a lot and do a lot of dictionary work. And always write down the exceptional nouns in a separate place. And from time to time, read the list. This is the best way to keep in mind which noun is masculine and which noun is feminine. Also, this habit will grow a sense of identification in you. Whenever you will be reading, you yourself will be able to find out if a noun is masculine or feminine. Hack number two.
If you can find out
the meanings of the nouns and they are living beings, you may find out easily if the noun is masculine or feminine. Like we all can understand, these are masculine singular nouns. Père, frère, fils, garçon, homme, papa. And these are feminine nouns. Mère, sœur, fille, femme, dame, maman. By seeing in the dictionary, you can easily find out if a noun is masculine or feminine. Hack number three.
Grammarians have figured out some ending parts which may help you find out
if a noun is masculine or feminine. Of course, along with your exceptional nouns list. Here it is. Nouns ending in S-E-O-N, T-E-O-N, A-E-S-O-N, A-N-C-E, E-N-C-E, T-E accent aigu, U-D-E, A-L-E, O-L-E, and U-R-E are all feminine nouns. There could be exceptions. If you find any, please share them in the comment section. Examples: la traduction, la version, la nation, la terminaison, la connaissance, la patience, la beauté, la certitude, la plénitude, la cathédrale, la parole, la culture, la facture. Nouns ending in A-S-M-E, I-S-M-E, E-A-U, M-E-N-T, A-C-L-E are usually masculine. There could be exceptions to this and let me know in the comment section. Examples: l'enthousiasme, le sarcasme, le classicisme, le couteau, l'enseignement, l'enseignement, le gouvernement, le spectacle. I will talk about more nouns and more detailed differences between masculine and feminine nouns later on in my upcoming videos. Let's see the answers of the questions which I have asked at the beginning. Une sœur, un marché, une chambre, une culture, une profession. This much for today. Read more and more and do more dictionary work. And thanks for watching the video till the end. Merci. Au revoir.